Welcome to Mystery Biology. Let's learn something new. Today, I'm going to talk about the basics of coronavirus. First, I'll start with the introduction, then I'll cover signs, symptoms, structure, diagnosis, and treatment. So let's start. Corona is a Latin word which means crown. These viruses are given this name because when we look under the electron microscope, they appear as crown. That is the crown-shaped glycoprotein protruding from its surface. It was first originated in seafood market of Wuhan, China on 31st December 2019 and it is responsible for the present pandemic. It is largest among the RNA virus. Formerly, it was named as novel coronavirus. Why the name novel? Novel means new, something that is not defined previously. Later, the name changed and the name given was SARS-CoV-2. SARS-CoV-2 stands for Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus 2 and the disease it causes is COVID-19. Here, CO stands for corona, VI for virus and D is for disease. And the digit 19 stands for the year when the actual outbreak occurred and this whole name was given by WHO. The mode of transmission is from human to human and it spreads from oral or nasal droplets. The incubation period is from 2 to 14 days. Phylogenetic analysis found a pet origin for the SARS-CoV-2. The coronavirus affects both animal and human. Here in this picture, we can see the three coronaviruses have crossed the species barrier to cause the deadly pneumonia-like symptoms since the beginning of 21st century. In the first case, we can see the SARS-CoV, the outbreak year was 2002 and it occurred in China. Here, the virus transmitted from bat to civet and from civet to human. When a virus transmits from an animal to human, then it is called the zoonotic transmission. In the second case, MERS-CoV, MERS stands for Middle East Respiratory Syndrome. The outbreak here is 2012 and it occurred in Saudi Arabia. Here, the virus transmitted from bat to camel and from camel to human. In the third case, SARS-CoV-2, the virus transmitted from bat to pangolin. Here, pangolin, the intermediate host, is not very clear. It is still under investigation. The virus transmitted from intermediate host to human. Now, let's see the classification of this coronavirus. Coronavirus has the order nidovirals, which has four family: Artiviridae, Ronaviridae, Mesoviridae, and Coronaviridae. Coronaviridae has two subfamilies, Coronavirinae and Torovirinae. Coronavirinae subfamily has four genus: Alpha coronavirus, Beta coronavirus, Delta coronavirus, and Gamma coronavirus. At present, we have 7 human coronavirus. 2 of them belongs to alpha coronavirus, that is HCoV-229E, HCoV-NL63, while 5 of them belongs to beta coronavirus, which contains HCoV-HKU1, HCoV-OC43, SARS-CoV, MERS-CoV and SARS-CoV-2. Now let's see the structure. As I have already told you, the coronavirus belongs to the family Coronaviridae. It is enveloped virus which contains positive sense single-stranded RNA. The genome is of 30 kilobase pair in length which contains helically symmetrical nucleocapsid. Here in this picture, we can clearly see that these red dots represent the spike proteins. And these spike proteins interact with the ACE2 receptor present on the epithelial cells of the respiratory tract of human. From the investigation, we can see the binding affinity of SARS-CoV-2 to the ACE2 receptor is higher than the SARS-CoV virus. After entry into the host cell, these viruses start replicating its RNA genome by hijacking the host machinery. After so many divisions, these viruses come out by bursting or killing the host cell. The symptoms can be mild in some individuals, while it can be very severe to another one. So we'll see the symptoms. The symptoms can be fever, dry cough, sore throat, nasal obstruction, shortness of breath, loss of taste or smell, or it can be headache. For the diagnosis, we do the real-time PCR. For that, we need samples. Those samples can be tracheal aspirate, sputum, nasal aspirate, or swab test. For the tracheal aspirate, a thin tube with the attached torch, also known as the bronchoscope, is used to reach your lung, which takes sample. Sputum, and the second is the sputum. Sputum is thick mucus which sometimes comes out with a cough. That sputum is collected for real-time PCR. For the nasal aspirate, we hear a healthcare worker inject saline into your nose and then a sample is collected with a light suction. For the swab test, we use a special swab which collects the sample from your throat or nose. From all these samples, we do the nucleic acid extraction, from which the RNA is extracted, and that RNA we use in real-time PCR to detect the presence of virus. Other tests are also there, which is based on antigen-antibody interaction, that is the immunoassay. First is the rapid antibody test. Rapid means that means it gives the result within 10 to 15 minutes. And this test is used to detect the antibody developed into the patient's body after the infection. In the second case, antigen test, here the samples are taken from nose or throat or lung, and then we detect the viral protein or antigen related to COVID-19. It mainly consists of monoclonal antibody, which detects the epitope on the surface of SARS-CoV-2. Unfortunately, there is no treatment available for COVID-19. Only supportive therapies are available. From the present investigations, we can see that the plasma therapy is working well in some individuals. Next is the vaccine, which is still under development, because it takes a lot of time to develop a vaccine which can work for everyone. The only way to prevent is by maintaining the social distancing or by avoiding public gathering, frequent hand washing, personal hygiene. Other measures are also there. We can frequently disinfect the surface after coming in contact with. We can use sanitizer or wash our hands again and again. We should use tissue to cover our mouth while sneezing or cough. In my next video, I will discuss more about the spike protein and the mode of transmission of this virus. Thank you.